put this all together. It was Saturday, it rained before, it's a corporate event, it's at a venue that I've showed you before, it's called the Amber Room, it's in Danbury, Connecticut, and here I am setting up. So let's go through it. Loading, the loading score is 9, I gave it to you guys last time. Straight, easy, we had to go through the kitchen, so I gave it a little ding, but no issues at all, I was able to get all my stuff in. I was running solo for this one. Wife Hands wasn't there, she's traveling. So it made things a little bit more challenging not having the wifey there, but we still made it happen. Got into the venue, wanted to set up my own uplight, so I did that. For this gig, I thought this was the perfect opportunity to showcase the RCF EVOX and what they can do versus the other system that I brought, which was the EV ELX200. 12 P's matched with the 18-inch subs, and I brought 2 subs and 2 tops. Those rocked, those I had no issues with. In fact, last year I remember I didn't even get to half on my mixer volume. I was very confident last year with that system. I've been rocking the EVOX12s this year, so I really wanted to try this system and to test it out and see what happens. This was a corporate event, so I was able to do that for this event because, you know, it's mainly quiet music for a majority of the event, and then we turn it up at the end. So I thought this was pretty appropriate. Now for the lighting, I brought my Chinese lights. These are the bar lights that I've showcased on my channel. Please check out my channel for that. You can see the video that I made. So these are battery operated LED bar lights, and it's controlled via a remote. I did not want to run any DMX for these particular lights, but if you were inclined, you definitely could run these through DMX and probably get a lot more out of what I've got out of this system. Now, let's talk about these lights. These lights are extremely, extremely bright. In sound mode, it's very effective, but I thought they were just too imposing for this particular event. So I turned on sound mode for a little bit because I wanted to showcase that to you guys particularly. And then I decided to just put it on fade and snap mode. Because these were really, really bright. So if you're considering these lights, fear not, these are really, really bright. It lit up the entire dance floor. And this was a huge, huge dance floor. You saw from last year and you're seeing now, this was a huge dance floor and we're able to lit the entire dance floor with just 6 of these lights. Now, my setup. I did have my custom booth. I rested my custom booth on my Rockville totem and I actually used the black scrim this time. You know, I was going for that Oreo look, you know, the black and the white, the tuxedo look, some may call it. And I think I achieved that. You know, I wanted to do something a little different for this event. Again, it was a corporate event, so I thought it was a perfect opportunity to showcase some differences. I do have my Serato going on my MacBook Pro, which is controlled by the Rain 1. The Rain 1 is housed in my custom booth. And, you know, the sound from the Rain 1 is routed to my Yamaha MG06X mixer, and then from the Yamaha MG06X mixer, I'm going out to each side of my EVOX12s. I only ran the EVOX12s for this event. I didn't use any other auxiliary speaker or any side fills. I was playing towards the dance floor last year. I brought the bigger system and I thought that was a little too much. So I really, really thought the EVOX would be appropriate. The EVOX got as loud as I needed them to. Maybe I felt like I was missing in the bass department, only because last year I had 2 18-inch subs and, you know, you can't mess with physics. These are 15s versus the 18s, so there will be a difference. But, you know, for this particular event, I don't think anyone really noticed that I didn't bring my 18s. I gotta say though, next year, if I do this event again, I'm definitely bringing my 18s because I do like the rumble in this particular room of the 18 versus the EVOX 12s. But if you have the EVOX 12s for this room, it'll work as well. Now, I gotta discuss one issue with the EVOX 12 that a lot of people discuss in the forums and I've seen, but I personally haven't experienced yet. And for some reason, for this particular night, I did. With the EVOX 12s and the way how it was sat on the poles, my top kept turning and I kept having to go and turn it back. So if you see in the dancing portion, you're gonna see most people to my left, your right when you look at the video, most people were concentrated to that side. And it was because the top was rotated to that side and it kept doing that. Now, I could have solved this by just putting a gaff tape on the pole or, you know, doing something that limit the rotation. But while in the mix and in the event, it's pretty difficult and pretty tough to do that. If I had wife hand there, I probably would have done it. But it wasn't an issue. People were on the dance floor, they danced. This was a very eclectic group, just like most of my events. It was a wide range of ages from 20, I believe, all the way up to 80. So I mixed it up. I played a lot of different types of music. I played from old to young. All in all, I thought it was a wonderful event. But yeah, enough of me talking. Check out the event. Let's go. Alright, so that was the event. Yeah, man, I had a lot of fun. I definitely miss wife hands on this one with the videography, with the support. So yo, shout out to you wife hands. I know you're enjoying your time on your vacation. Love you. Yo, make sure you like, make sure you subscribe. Lavish Life DJ Peck. Peace.